So 4-0 win and four wins on the bounce. Talk me through the game.
Yeah, they're good. Moved the ball well. I think we limited them to a lot in front of us, which we're good at. We like to play against teams that play out. I think we press with an intent. We get our organisation right. We're aggressive when they go back to front with our 1v1 duel. So, yeah, I think could have been a little bit more productive in the final third. And I mean, not finishing, I meant can we play forward, think forward quicker? But, yeah, the best thing for me is, you said a win, I say third or fourth clean sheet in a row. I think it's the third one now. So, to get a dot by our name come the 90, I think is the most pleasing thing. Deliveries into the box is paramount. We've been good tonight, I have to say that. Don't get carried away. The best thing is clean sheet, no injuries. We move on now to a session Monday and prep for the game against Hitchin on Wednesday.
You talked a lot about fitness as well throughout this whole pre-season. How do you think the fitness levels were today?
Yeah, I think they're good. The S&C boys, along with the medical team, done an anonymous survey yesterday. Sent it into their group just to see where the players felt they were standing, and some of them put a score out of 7, 5 and 6, which alludes to it being a tough pre-season. Where they see themselves in terms of their fitness levels, the highest mark was 80 to 90%, which is probably perfect at this stage in the pre-season schedule. And I honestly believe what they're recording I'm seeing. I look at our recovery runs, our counters at times, our initial press, 5-yard fury. Yeah, I think it was good. And I have to say that making them four changes doesn't affect the team. To bring on Jamal Fifield, Frankie Raymond, Josh Reese and Jack Munns shows the depth in the squad we got. We've got a good quality group there. And yeah, I think that they've gone and put on a performance tonight. You're talking to a lot of people, a lot of my mates are Arsenal and they come over and said very impressive. So yeah, like I said, I'm not being fun. I can't get carried away with it. Reason being is you don't win nothing in pre-season, but we're seeing good bits and good habits that the boys are taking on board, and people probably won't notice throw-ons, goal kicks, little things, little factors that we've spoken about disrupting the opposition in their half. So yeah, they're the bits that I'm happy with. The boys thoroughly deserve a weekend off. This weekend, they've gone and had a tough week. Monday training, Tuesday game against Chelsea, Thursday good session to then go and put on a performance tonight. So I'll look forward to welcoming them back in on Monday. I've told them they're going to work ever so hard, and then we'll be in prep for Wednesday. So as it stands at the minute, happy. Is there bits we need to improve on? 100%. Is there bits that I'm happy with? Yeah, but for me, I'm always finding that little percentage to improve on.
And when you said Wednesday, that might well be the last game of pre-season. How much are you looking forward to not just that game, but the 21st as well, when we head to Weymouth?
Will be the last game. Obviously, the 14th is a conundrum for a lot of sides in our level, because the EFL started tonight, or Championship started tonight. And then you've got the Premiership side starting on the 14th. You've got their 23s and B sides starting their calendar. So for us to go to Hitchin on Wednesday gives us a 10-day period to really knuckle down on what we want to get out of the game against Weymouth. And I am excited. I feel there's a new club, and I spoke to the chairman today, funny enough, that's been built in the off-season. Personnel going out the building, personnel coming in the building, and I don't mean just in the first team structure, I'm talking across the board. And yeah, there's an energy to us, there's a purpose to us, and we're finally back to our dysfunctional family, which I adore.